Hi everyone, my name is Dan and I'm a Canva Certified Creative. Today, I'm excited to share with you guys how to design a professional LinkedIn banner using Canva. So let's get started. So first of all, you're gonna go to the canva.com homepage and then you're gonna use the search bar. Since today we're designing a LinkedIn banner, we're just gonna go ahead and type in LinkedIn banner. And there's gonna be two different options, but we're gonna go ahead and select the smaller one. So as you see here, there are plenty of different templates to choose from, but I wanted to create our own custom LinkedIn banner. So we're gonna go ahead and click on this button here. And if you wanted to use one of Canva's own templates, you can just look over to the left-hand side. But since we're creating something from scratch, we're not going to be using these templates. So first of all, make sure that you have your brand style guide already uploaded onto Canva. So for example, you can see I have the coffee date and also the colors as well. So I'm just gonna go ahead and click on this and I want to change the color. So I'm gonna go ahead and hover over to the background color, select that, and we're gonna go ahead and choose something a little bit lighter. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose this. And of course, you don't have to follow the exact same colors. Go ahead and use your brand colors. So this is what we have for the background. And now we're gonna go ahead and go over to elements and we're gonna go ahead and select the lines and shapes tool. I'm gonna go ahead and choose a square. We're gonna go ahead and move it over to here and pull it out a little bit just so it looks like this. And then we're gonna go ahead and tilt this over just so that it gives it that cutoff look, which I really like because it brings a lot of dimension to the design. We're gonna go ahead and just scoot over and I'm actually gonna change this from this dark pink color to a white color, which is here. Perfect. So it looks like this for now. And we're gonna go ahead and lock this down. So basically locking it down means that we can't move it. So now go to your uploads and I highly recommend using a photo of yourself. This is if you want to. For this exact banner, I've uploaded a few photos here, but I'll go ahead and use this one. So I'm just gonna go ahead and drag it over like so. And I'm going to drag it to make it larger until it looks like this. So we're gonna use this nifty tool and to use that, we're gonna go ahead to click edit image and then it's called the background remover tool. So go ahead and click that. So as you guys can see here, the tool has completely removed the background, but I want to make it a little bit larger just so it stands out more. So we're just gonna go ahead and make it a little bit larger until it looks like this. And I think that's good enough. And we're gonna go ahead and lock it down. And now we're gonna spice up our banner by adding in some elements. So Canva provides us with tons of great elements. And I think for LinkedIn, it's very important to choose the elements that you think appeal the most to your target audience. What makes sense for your brand? So for me, I'm a blogger, so I'm gonna go ahead and type in computer, for example. And Canva provides you with photos, graphics, videos, or audio. So we're gonna go ahead and work with graphics for this tutorial. And there's tons of great graphics for you to choose from. But I'm gonna go ahead and choose this one here because I think it appeals the most to me. So we're just gonna make it larger. And we're gonna brand everything just so that we stay on brand. So instead of this pink color, I'm gonna choose this pink color. Instead of purple, I'll go ahead and choose the same pink. Instead of this color, I'll go ahead and choose white. Actually, let's go ahead and choose gray actually. And then instead of blue, we're gonna go ahead and choose this pale pink color. So we're gonna go ahead and move this over until it cuts halfway and we're gonna right click and click send backward. So it looks like this. And we're gonna make it a little bit smaller. And I think it looks great right now. So the really cool thing about Canva is after you've chosen your first element, there's also magic recommendations. So you can click see all and you'll get all these recommendations. But for me, since I already know the graphics that attract my target audience, I'm gonna go ahead and choose recently used graphics. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose this one. We're gonna go ahead and choose this one, this gear icon. This heart one would be really nice as well. And then we're also gonna choose this one. So now our job is just to make sure everything's on brand. So I'm gonna go ahead and change this all from black to white. Now, we're gonna go ahead and position all these elements around this computer. So to do that, we're just gonna go ahead and select all of these images and make it a little bit smaller because they're a little bit too large right now. And we're gonna position it like so. And you can see it's still a little bit too big, so I'm just gonna make it a little bit smaller. So I think it looks good like this. So we're gonna go ahead and play with the transparency a little bit. So we're gonna go ahead and select all of these images and we're just gonna make it a little bit transparent. So let's try at 65. Okay, I think that looks great. So now we're just gonna move it over a little bit because it can look a little bit cluttered. I think this is good for now. So you're gonna go back and you're gonna go ahead and choose the line and shapes tool. And we're gonna go ahead and use this circle. And I want to make a dark pink color, but this is a little bit too dark. So I'm going to go ahead and just change the transparency. And we're going to go ahead and see how it looks like at 30. So you can go ahead and click here and type in 30. So I think 30 is fine. And we're going to use this just to make our elements pop a little bit more. So I'm going to make it a little bit smaller. And I'm going to move it over here. And we're going to right click and click send backward. So it looks like so. You know, on second thought, I think these icons are a little bit too light. So we're gonna go ahead and select all of them again and just change the transparency all the way up to 100. And I think that looks a little bit better. And we see that it's a little bit too close. So I'm just gonna go ahead and move these icons a little bit further out like so. And now you see that we have tons of space to play around with here. So I'm gonna go ahead and make our heart a little bit bigger, like so. And we're gonna go ahead and add in some more color to this banner. So go over to the lines and shapes tool and we're gonna go ahead and select the circle tool and pull it over. We're gonna remember that the transparency of this was 30. So we're gonna go ahead and make sure that it matches the same. So I'm gonna go over to this tool and go ahead and change it from 100 to 30. And we're just gonna move it over here. And you can go ahead and fill in the rest of the banner with any elements you like. I'm gonna go ahead and add in some more. And if you have your logo, you can go ahead and add your logo to the left-hand side here. But I'm gonna go ahead and pretend that I don't have a logo ready. So I'm gonna go ahead and make my own logo. So I'm gonna go ahead and select this square tool and move it to here. But I'm gonna change this from this color. We're gonna go ahead and change it to white. So it looks like so. And I'm gonna go ahead and add in some text. Since my name is Diana Trin, I'm gonna go ahead and just put my logo as if it were DT. So we're gonna go ahead and make this a little bit larger and dark. And I'm gonna change the color from black to gray. I'm gonna go ahead and move over it so it looks like this. But it's a little bit too large, so we're gonna add in some extra padding. So we're gonna decrease the font size so it looks like that. So we're gonna go ahead and add some text to our banner. So I'm just gonna choose a heading text. So I'll move this over here and I want to make it larger. So I'm gonna go ahead and just increase the size. So it looks like this. And I think it's very important to think again about your target audience and what people can expect when they visit your LinkedIn profile. So I'm gonna go ahead and type in marketing for creatives. And I want it to align to the left. So I'll click here so it looks like this. And we're gonna go ahead and just move it over like so. I think the text is a little bit large, so we're just gonna go ahead and make it a little bit smaller. So it looks like this. So now we really want to make sure that this text is highlighted or stands out. So we're gonna go over to elements again, and we're gonna choose the lines and shapes tool. I'm gonna go ahead and choose a square, like so. And I just want to hover it over like this. And I really think that this pink is a little bit too harsh, so I'm gonna go ahead and choose the same color as the background. So it's gonna be this pale pink here. And I think that looks much better. And we're gonna do the same for this part as well. So just choose a square tool. Like this, perfect. And then we're just add some padding. And perfect. We're gonna change it to the same color, this pale pink. And I just wanna make sure it's lined up. And yes, it looks lined up. And I also want to go ahead and add in some more text. So we're just gonna go back to the text tool and we're gonna go ahead and add in a little bit of body text. So I'm just gonna go ahead and drag it over and I'm gonna make it larger so it's easier to see. And I will go ahead and put follow for marketing and blogging tips. This just makes it easier for visitors to know exactly what type of content they can expect when they visit my LinkedIn. So So I'm just gonna go ahead and move it over to here. And since I really want them to line up, I'm gonna go ahead and move all of this as well. So we're gonna go ahead and just go like this. Perfect. Thanks so much for watching my tutorial, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys would like to learn more about me, you can go ahead and visit my website at www.thecoffeedate.com. Bye!